now we'll be learning about each and every nutrients of the food in detail. So what is the first one? We are going to start with carbohydrates. So what are carbohydrates? As discussed before, carbohydrates are energy giving food. So the first point should be they are energy giving foods. Second one, as the name suggests, we have carbohydrates. It means that carbohydrates are hydrates of carbon. They are hydrates of carbon. Then, carbohydrates are mostly made up of three different types of materials. So, they are made of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. So they are made up of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. Next, 1 gram of carbohydrates can give up to 4.2 kilojoules per gram. So it can give you up to 4.2 kilojoules per gram, which is equal to 17 joules. So like it means that 1 gram of carbohydrates can give you up to 4.2 kilojoules per gram. Okay? So this, like 1 gram of carbohydrates can give you 4.2 kilojoules per gram of energy. So now there are like mainly three types of carbohydrates. So first one type is called as monosaturides. The second type is called as disaturides, and the third type are known as polysaturides. So let me write that down. So these are the main points for carbohydrates. So the next one is, they are of three types. So the first type is called monosaturide. First type is called monosaturide. The first type is called the monosaturide. The second type is called disaturide. And the third type is called polysaturide. So the first is monosaturide, disaturide, polysaturide. So you mainly know what is mono and what is di and what is poly. So mono means one and di means two. So if you take monosaturides, if you see the examples, we have glucose. So what are monosaturides? The carbohydrates or the sugars which have only one molecule. So let me first write down the definition. Having only one molecule so having only one molecules are monosaturated. So what are the example? Glucose. So glucose is an example. So if you see glucose, rather than glucose we can first write down the formula. So what is the formula? So we have C6H12O6. This is the formula for glucose. So, this thing is known as glucose. Okay, it is a glucose. But how does this glucose give us energy? So, to find out that, you need to understand this formula. So, here we have C6H12O6 plus 6O2 gives you 6CO2 plus 6H12. H2O plus energy. So this is the main formula. So C6H12O6. So what is the C6H12O6? This is glucose. So if there is glucose in your body, and then there is oxidation performed. So if there is oxidation going on with glucose, so like for example, oxidation is normally when we are breathing it, there is glucose inside our body. Then after the taking enough glucose, if we add the oxygen, so it gives us 6 carbon dioxide molecules plus 6 H2O water molecules plus energy. This energy is used by the body. So if you take about monosaccharides, so let me actually rub these things so that we can understand it more easily. So here if we take the monosaccharides, so as I said, C6H12O6 plus 6O2 gives 6CO2 plus 6H2O plus energy. So there is glucose in the body, so this is called glucose. If you provide oxygen to the glucose, it gives you some carbon dioxide, that is we exhale out, plus some water which is actually present in our body, plus energy. So this energy is being used to perform the different activities. So if you take about these monosaccharides, they do not require digestion. So they do not require digestion. What does that mean? So for example, if you see in your real life, let us take an example of real life. For example, if a person is going less on energy, or for example he has some problem and he's admitted in the hospital. So glucose, so like you might have observed that they are giving some drips of glucose. So what is this drip of glucose and why are we giving this? So glucose is a monosaccharide with the formula C6H12O6, which when performed with oxidation gives some energy to the body to give some proper energy for the body to perform some functions. But if a patient is having some problems in his digestive system, so it may not be able to digest whatever food it has. So what it does is, if we provide glucose to the patient, so glucose is directly absorbed by the blood and energy is being given to the body. It does not require any assimilation or absorption or anything. So that's why we all call it as a glucose, as monosaccharide, and they do not require digestion. Second type is, we have fructose. Fructose is also a monosaccharide. So this is also called fruit sugar. This is called fruit sugar. This is called fruit sugar. And then we have one more thing, that is galactose. Galactose is actually milk sugar. So you might think that what is lactose then? Lactose is actually a disaccharide. We'll be going to that for now. For now you can understand this. So what are monosaccharides? They have only one molecule of sugar. And if you see that this one molecule of sugar, so one molecule of sugar equals C6H12O6, that is one molecule. Why? Because in one molecule there are six carbon atoms, 12 hydrogen atoms and 6 oxygen atoms. So that is what only one molecule of sugar. Even in fructose there is even one molecule of sugar. So even fructose and galactose, they do not require digestion. Why they are only providing glucose? Because glucose is actually easily available. Because you can take any food, you can extract glucose from that. But taking fructose, it means you have to take the fruit sugar. And fruit sugar, like it is good for a limited amount. But if you take too much of fruit sugar, then you may get diabetes or different something else. Like diabetes or sugar. Then we have galactose, milk sugar. There is also lactose, that is actually the main milk sugar. Galactose is the half of lactose. It has only one molecule. So this was about monosaccharides. Now let us see about disaccharides. What are disaccharides? Di or bi, you can take either bi or you can take either di. So what is disaccharide? So let me write down. The sugars which have two molecules are called as disaccharides. Two molecules of sugar are disaccharides. So they have the formula C12H22O11. This is the formula for disaccharide. So like in the previous one we have seen it has C6H12O6. So 6 double is 12, 12 double is 24, but here we have 22, and 6 double is 12, but we have here 1. So we can say that they are almost double of monosaccharides. So they are almost double of monosaccharides. Like we can't say exactly, because there are two molecules missing in hydrogen and one molecule missing in oxygen. So you can say they are almost double of monosaccharide. So what are the examples in disaccharides? So the examples in disaccharides are table sugar. So what is table sugar? The sugar which we eat normally, or we can also say that is as sucrose. So what is sucrose? It is having one molecule of glucose and one molecule of fructose. So table sugar is called sucrose. So sucrose is made up of one molecule of glucose and one molecule of fructose. Then we have maltose. So what is maltose? Maltose is actually a malt sugar. Malt sugar. So what is malt sugar? So mainly like there are some drinks, like if you take for example Horlicks or Bonvita, you can see that they are in the form of malt. So that is what we mostly call it as malt sugar. So they are made up of mostly two glucose molecules. And the last one we have lactose. So lactose is actually called milk sugar. So what is maltose? Maltose is milk sugar, and it consists of glucose and galactose. One molecule of glucose plus one molecule of galactose. So these are what the disaccharides. So first one, the sugars which have two molecules of sugars, I mean they with the sugar which have the two molecules of sugars. So we can also call them as double sugar molecules, like which have the two sugar molecules are called disaccharides. So which have two molecules of sugar or two sugar molecules. So they have the formula C12H22O11. And one more point, they require digestion. So they require digestion. So the third one is, they are almost double of monosaccharides. So here this point is almost double, it's not exactly double. Then we have examples. So one of the example is table sugar. What is table sugar? It is called sucrose. So it is one molecule of glucose and one molecule of fructose plus one molecule of fructose. Then we have maltose. Maltose is malt sugar. So two glucose molecules, it's made up of two glucose molecules. Then we have lactose, which is milk sugar, which have one molecule of glucose plus one molecule of galactose. As I said in the previous monosaccharides, that galactose is actually one molecule. So if you add galactose and glucose, you get lactose. And then they require digestion. So if they are having in lactose, let me explain you one more thing. There are many people which have the problems that are known as lactose intolerance. So what is the meaning of lactose intolerance? So the meaning of lactose intolerance is that many people cannot bear the milk. For example, lactose intolerance means they cannot tolerate lactose in their body. They are sensitive to lactose. So that is what are called lactose intolerance. And this is about disaccharides. So the third one we are going to learn about polysaccharides. So let us see. So now we have our third type, which is actually called polysaccharide. So as the name suggests, polysaccharide means it contains three or more than three. So here in polysaccharide, it's not too much difficult to learn that because there is only two examples which I can explain you, but you can just learn it. So first one, what is it? Polysaccharide. Polysaccharides. So what are polysaccharides? They contain many molecules of sugar, that is three or more. Then we have, they are called complex sugars. They contain many molecules of sugar, that is they can contain three or more molecules of sugar. They are actually called complex sugars. Then we have only two examples, so starch and cellulose. So first starch. So what is starch? Starch, you can say that that is a polymer of glucose. So I can see that starch is polymer of glucose. So what do I mean by starch is a polymer of glucose? It means that glucose is made up of many starch molecules. Starch is made up of many glucose molecules. So starch is a polymer of glucose. It means that starch contains three or more than three molecules of glucose. So it has to be digested. It has to be digested. Third point, it has to be cooked. So for example, if you take potato, can you eat potato like that? Like, can you eat potato as a raw potato? No, you cannot eat. First, you have to cook the potato. So if you take potato is a rich, like it is rich in starch. It has a lot of starch. Like you can like say that potato has the largest number of starch present in vegetables. So it has to be cooked, like potato has to be cooked, then only it can provide energy. You can eat potato, but it won't provide you energy. You need to first cook the food, and then if you eat, then it will provide you energy. This is about starch. Then second one, we have cellulose. What is cellulose? So cellulose is a plant product. So this cannot be digested. So like if you see cellulose is actually a roughage. If cellulose is a roughage, why am I adding it in carbohydrate? Because cellulose comes both in carbohydrates and roughage. Why? Because cellulose has the same molecules. Why? Because if you take cellulose in plants, you may see that cellulose may have some fructose. Why? Because cellulose comes from plant, and plant has fruits, and fruit has fructose. So you can say that cellulose indirectly has some fructose molecules and some glucose molecules as well. So that is why we can add them under carbohydrate. Though cannot be digested, but helps in digestion. So now you may ask, where is the formula for this thing? So there is no exact formula, because if it is 2, we can like mostly like approximately double it. But if you take our polysaccharide, it may be 3, it may be 4, it may be 5. So there is no exact formula. If you want to find out 3, you can just multiply the first monosaccharide with 3 times. You can multiply the molecules. 4, you can multiply with 4 times. So but there may be some exceptions. So that's what, there is no specific values. So this was about carbohydrates. Now let us, so I hope it is enough for today's video. We'll be continuing this video in the next part, that is part number 3. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have enjoyed this video, do consider liking the video and subscribing to the channel. Press the bell icon so that you'll get tuned in for the next updated videos. Please, please, please like and share the video. Subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.